here at All Saints Church in Brighton Heights with the family of our good friend and former priest here at All Saints Church, Dick Pollard, to have morning prayers together on this first Sunday after Christmas Day, and to remember Dick and to dedicate and bless the memorial Advent Christmas Candelabra, which has been presented here at All Saints for the Indic's memory and to be a part of our ongoing worship life. And so we're going to begin this morning by praying together the collect for the first Sunday after Christmas Day, which is printed on our order of service this morning. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, who has poured upon us the new light of thine incarnate word, grant that the same light enkindled in our hearts may shine forth in our lives, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Together, Psalm 147, verses 13-21. Worship the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion. For he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you. He has established peace on your borders. He satisfies you with the promised wheat. He sends out his command to the earth, and his word runs very swiftly. He gives snow like wool. He scatters hoarfrost like ashes. He scatters his hail like breadcrumbs. Who can stand against his cold? He sends forth his word and melts them. He blows with his wind, and the waters flow. He declares his word to Jacob, his statutes and his judgments to Israel. He has not done so to any other nation. To them he has not revealed his judgments. Hallelujah.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. You may stand or sit.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
The Gospel reading appointed for the first Sunday after Christmas is from St. John, first chapter beginning at the first verse. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was light, and the light was the light of men. The light shines in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for He that cometh after me is preferred before me, for he was before me. And of his fullness have all we received, and grace for grace. For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came from Jesus Christ. No man hath seen God at any time, the only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, he hath declared him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be always acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our redeemer. Amen. Amen. So it's three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge and a pear tree. That's the third day of Christmas, which this year is the first Sunday after Christmas Day. It's a very different Christmas this year for all of us, and the COVID-19 all around us, but with all of those differences, I do pray that the deeper meaning of this season continues to be refreshing and renewing for us. On Christmas Eve and Christmas morning, we were with Mary and Joseph and the baby in the manger and the shepherds out in the fields and the angels singing up in the heavens, and today we hear, as Wade has just read for us, this new creation story in the first chapter of John. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. In him was life, the life was the light of men, and light shineth in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. The Greek says, that pitched his tent among us. We beheld his glory, glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. So we've heard the story of the baby in the manger, and now John tells us what that story is all about, the glory of God pushing back the darkness, lifting us into his cleansing and perfecting life, filling us and blessing us with that life. So we here at All Saints had meant to dedicate this Advent Christmas Candelabra, and remember our good friend and pastor and priest Dick Pollard, the Sunday morning communion service with the whole congregation back at the beginning of Advent, but all of that got scrambled within the midst of the pandemic. But in the end, I think the first Sunday after Christmas Day, with this wonderful reading from St. John, turns out to be a perfect day to be lighting some candles and remembering Dick in two ways. First of all, any candle in church almost always signifies to us one thing above everything else, and that is the light of Christ shining in the darkness, the glory of God, his mercy, his love, his deep humility, God kneeling down beside us, taking on our human nature, giving himself for us as a sacrifice for sin, an example of the life that we would want to live. Christ is the light of the world, and every candle that we light reminds us of that. The four Advent candles, the three purple and the one rose-colored candles, remind us Sunday by Sunday during Advent of God's great promises, the promise of the first Advent, the promise of Christmas morning, the life of Jesus and his death for us on the cross, his Easter morning resurrection, his ascending into heaven with the rules and glory, right hand of the Father. And the promise of the second Advent as well, as we know, he shall come again to judge the quick and the dead, and to raise us into glory and everlasting life. And that Christ candle, the white candle in the center, that reminds us that while we remember Jesus at Christmas, and while we await his coming again, we also have the promise that he would send us his Holy Spirit to be with us here and now, today, right? In 2020, that he would be with us to comfort us, to care for his church, to nurture us through scripture, sacrament, and prayer. So it's the light of Christ at Christmas, the light of Christ at the end of time, and his light with us now. So secondly, I think this John reading is perfect for us this morning because of John the Baptist. And I, as Wade was reading, I thought to myself, there was a man sent from God whose name was Richard. John the Baptist was sent by God to prepare the way. He was sent not to be the light, but to point to the light, to bear witness to the light, that all men through him might believe. I can't think of a better patron saint for a pastor and a priest than John the Baptist. Dick Pollard, husband, father, grandfather, he was a good friend. He was a colleague of mine and of Wade's for many years. He was a fine priest. People of this church really enjoyed the time he spent there here with them. He was funny. Sometimes his sense of humor took a little while to get used to, my personal impression, but he was funny. He was very warm, very affectionate, and it's just telling to me that even so many years later, Dick's presence is still so very much with people of this congregation. When I was getting ready to retire last year from my full-time ministry, Bishop McConnell invited me to come over and help out here some at Brighton Heights, and I ran into Dick at one of those clergy things that we were doing early in the year, and when I told him that I would be coming over here, you could just see a certain brightness in his eyes. He enjoyed that. He had a few stories to tell about Brighton Heights, stories which I will not repeat, because he was a great storyteller. But Susan, I was thinking of something that you said when we were talking about this a little while ago. How when Dick was over at St. Paul's, and that great big church with many priests on staff and many priests as members of the congregation, how he felt really struck by a call to step away from all of that, where there was a lot of rich ministry to be done for sure, and to offer his ministry here in one of the smallest congregations of our diocese, a place where it's been very difficult to have a priest in place for any extended period of time, and that's been for a long, long time. He made that step with sincerity, with love, and that love was returned in so many ways. It just was wonderful to see. He was not the light, but he was sent to bear witness to the light. John the Baptist and Dick Pollard, pointing to Jesus, preparing the way for Jesus to be known in every place. Again, I can't think of a better image for priest and pastor than that. So I'm thankful, among so many others, to be following in Dick's footsteps here at Brighton Heights. He's a great role model and example, and I know for all of the congregation and for many years to come, we're going to see this Advent and Christmas Candelabra as we worship Advent Sunday all the way through the season of Christmas every year as a reminder of that wonderful ministry that they have with us. John, bear witness of him, bear witness of Jesus, and cried, saying, "This was he of whom I spake. He that cometh after me is preferred before me, for he was before me. And of his fullness have we all received, grace for grace. For the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. No man hath seen God at any time. The only begotten Son, which is in the bosom of the Father, he hath declared him." So I really do give thanks for Dick today for his ministry. I remember him as friend and colleague and know him in this place as pastor and priest. I give thanks for his wonderful family as we gather here today. We love you all so much. And most of all, I'm thankful for the witness that he had in so many different parts of our life and our diocese and the wider church. And I'm very thankful that we're able to honor him in this way today. And I know that honoring and that regard will continue for many years to come. So God bless you all. And now we're going to move down to the candelabra, and we're going to light and then dedicate this beautiful remembrance. Thank you. But I think we can all come up here to be around that, and I think Rima is trying to handle the candle lighting.
Push it all a little more. Please be seated. Now, obviously, I'm not Jim Shuker with his gift of handling, but I'm not going to try to tell any stories about Dick. I only want you to know I've known him a long time. I served with him more than once as deacon here at All Saints. I've known him a long time in the diocese, and I'm just very happy for my association with Dick. In fact, it was here that I realized he was driving a Jeep. I never saw him drive a Jeep, except he pulled up one Sunday here, and he was in his Jeep. I think it was beige. I don't remember. But anyway, after Dick started the ministry down in Bridgeville, I don't know how many times over the 30 years I've been here that I was assigned to All Saints, but Christine McElvain and I, she's the deacon at Christ Church, and I was there 7 years after leaving the cathedral, and for a while we actually came every other Sunday, I believe, or maybe to do a deacon's mass, and maybe once a month, or maybe longer, there would be a priest here. But I know after Dick went down to Bridgeville, I was in a difficult time in my life, and I was suffering some depression. And I just got to the point where I felt I wasn't able to do a good job running the service and actually preaching sermons. And one Sunday, when I was feeling my worst, I looked out in the congregation before I preached, and Dick was sitting up there. So I teased him about it later, and I said he was here to spy on me. But actually, it made me feel very good. More than one instance, as Dick helped me through some difficult periods. So I'm thankful for his friendship and for knowing him as a priest. June 9th, 2014, and again on Sunday, December 27th, the Reverend Richard A. Pollard. Dear Father Dick, on this first day of Pentecost, we celebrate the arrival of the Holy Spirit. And with the power of the Holy Spirit, believers receive gifts of the Spirit. And some like you have been given the gifts of teaching and preaching and encouragement. You have used these gifts in your ordained ministry, and our parish has been the beneficiary. We crafted our bread banner to be a fitting tribute not only for your years of ordained ministry, but also in thanksgiving for the loving service that you have provided our parish. And today, we once again offer a sign of our thanksgiving in the memorial dedication of the Advent and Christmas Candelabra. At a time when we did not have a full-time priest, you shared your Spirit-filled gifts of teaching and preaching at many of our Sunday services. At the conclusion of this service, you used your gift of encouragement as you counseled us on parish endeavors. In addition to help on Sunday mornings, you shared your time with homebound and hospitalized parishioners and brought them the sacrament. You were readily available to help the senior warden and the vestry about worship service questions or how to obtain information from the diocese. Other times, you would use your gift of humor to lighten our load, ease our worries, and warm the atmosphere. With your help, you were able to look forward. You shared your gifts with so many of us. When you were ordained the bishop charge, in all you do, you are to nourish Christ's people from the riches of his grace and strengthen them to glorify God in this life and in the life to come. You have nourished us and strengthened us, and you have used your gifts of the Spirit to help us glorify God. We cannot thank you enough for all that you have done for us. We are truly blessed by you. The Parish of All Saints Episcopal Church in Brighton Heights. All I ask today is that you remember Father Dick on many services, especially on a day when it would be a Steelers game. He would be wearing his black and gold Steelers stole. Who knows where it is today?
I'm still looking for it.
Thank God for Dick. Thank you.
faith, Father, shepherd of your people. We thank you for your servant Richard, who was faithful in the care and nurture of your flock. We pray that following this example, the teaching of his holy life, we may, by your grace, grow into the stature of the fullness of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
So, Lord God, bless this wreath, and bless us as well. May this wreath remind us of the hope and joy that Jesus brings into the world. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you, remain with you this day and always. Amen.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God. God.